News and info that matters to you on WWL. Always live on the free Odyssey app. Tweet us at WWL News Dave. I'm in Dr. Bob. I'm on Heather. Thanks for calling. What's on your mind?
Yes, I want to say I talk about like the adventures and all that. That wonderful stuff that you have to talk about. My question is about, you know, I heard like you guys saying that there was like, you know, we can only travel certain kinds of travel for like the super rich, and I'm kind of curious, like, what does that mean for the general public? Like, what would be considered super, super rich? Are we talking millions of dollars, or is it just like $200 or so?
Well, you heard him say that they'd be able to, like the Richard Branson experience, where he said to go up and see a guy with, see this guy from the blue to black and see the stars, and we're waiting for 9 minutes, and then you come right back down to Earth. So he thinks that'll be about the price of an expensive cruise in the next 10 to
12
months. So you're talking thousands of dollars and millions of dollars for that. But if you want to go live in space, you want to go to the moon, you want to go to Mars, they're going to be extremely wealthy or be in that.
Right. Okay. All right. Well, thank you. It's been really, really wonderful to see you guys.
Thanks, Kevin. There was a company a few years ago that had a dream of taking volunteers to let them live on Mars. They said that they would bring them back, that they only had the technology to get you there. They didn't have it to get you back. And they, that company's business model failed. They didn't end up moving forward with that plan because, well, I guess they just left some people going to go to live as long as they could on Mars with the hope that there'd be enough resupply and that could be a long life. Ultimately, you would die on Mars. Now, Elon Musk wants to die on Mars, but he doesn't want it in that factor. He wants it to be a building, a place to live on Mars, and that's just fine. Justin, thanks for calling. You're on
WWL. Good morning, Dave. I would love to go visit Mars, but on one condition, that my plane gets to bring me back to Earth.
Yeah, well, that's now they're going to win. NASA's not going to bring people on Mars. Their plan is to colonize the moon and then launch from the moon, because it takes far less energy to launch from the moon than it does to launch from Earth. It takes the energy to then launch the mission. But it's still a fucking big people trip to get from the moon to Mars.
Now, there's one structure on Mars that I want to pick on. Structure is the natural thing. Okay. It's the largest formation, the largest volcano in the solar system called Olympus Mars. And I've seen pictures of it from space, and they're telling me that if I was on the ground, I could never see the top of it. It's so big. And I would love to, you know, fly over it and take pictures of it. Oh my God, I'd love to see that, but I have to come home.
And they will bring the astronauts home from Mars, at least that's the plan. We'll see. You know, we're talking still decades before people are being on Mars. I think America is very hungry to plan to do it, as they want to get to Mars also. But some ideas, like first I want to go get a giant breakfast out of California, but that's not nice. And then I'm sure I'm supposed to go see the giant, the largest formation. Land formation that we could actually access. You know, there are limitations. I just wonder, you know, in all the science fiction, we find ways to travel to other solar systems, travel around the
moon.
And I don't know if, you know, there are a lot of things we do now that we thought would never be possible. But I just don't know if we'll ever be able to travel at the highest speed to allow us to get to other places like that, even if we do take off now. That take years to get there. I don't
you're
know.
You're talking about transportation.
Yeah, we're in
transport room.
Well, transportation is another issue, but also traveling at the speed of light and other things.